Sing to the Lord and rejoice. Sing to the Lord and rejoice. For He
the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are in the third week of the resurrection. Thursday, and let our petitions be included in this Holy Mass. Coming together as God's family, let us ask the Lord's forgiveness for our wrongdoings. All together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my most grievous fault.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord, our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty and ever-living God, let us feel your compassion more readily during these days when by your gift we have known it more fully, so that those you have freed from the darkness of error may cling more firmly to the teaching of your truth. We ask this, O Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, "Get up and head south on the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza, the desert route." So he got up and set out. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, that is the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with that chariot." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I, unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. Like a sheep, he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before his shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who will tell of his posterity? For his life is taken from the earth. Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or someone else? Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with this scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, Look, there is water. What is to prevent by being baptized? Then he ordered the chariot to stop, and Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his way, rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God, our responsorial son. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Bless our God, the peoples, loudly sound his praise. He has given life to our souls, and he has not let our feet slip.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Hear now, all you who fear God, while I declare what he's done to me. When I appealed to him in words, praise was on the tip of my tongue.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Blessed be God who refused me not, my prayer or his kindness.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Please all stand.
Proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, No one come to me unless the Father who sent me drew him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, These shall all be taught by God. Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. My dear sisters and brothers, the good news of our salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Welcome to the National Shrine and Parish of Saint Padre Pio. Since Monday, we had been hearing the Bread of Life discourse of Jesus in the account of John the Evangelist. The Jewish crowd is focused on Jesus as coming from Nazareth and as the son of Joseph, that they refuse to believe the origin, the true origin of Jesus, that is from above and sent by the Heavenly Father. To believe where Jesus come from, or to believe the origin of Jesus, first, one must have a confidence in Jesus that He is telling the truth, revealing the kingdom of God, the kingdom of His Father. Secondly, one must also allow himself to be drawn and taught by the Father, as mentioned into this reading. Human intelligence or human ability alone is not enough to believe in Jesus. Grace is necessary. In the account of Matthew, Jesus affirms Peter's confession of him as a Messiah. In affirming that statement of Peter, Jesus said, "Flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Heavenly Father." To be drawn to Jesus and to have faith in Him implies that one must listen to and learn the will of the Father. That is why in Jesus conveying to the audience of His time, He insisting every time that He is teaching the audience that His Father and Him is one. They are consubstantial. And in this, in a mirror effect, those who are listening and learn from Jesus would be allowed to see the Father. Later, Jesus will tell Philip that whoever has seen me has seen the Father. This is the consubstantiality of the Son and the Father. Perhaps the challenge for us in these readings for today, the first reading, and even the psalm, the responsorial psalm, and the gospel, especially the gospel, Jesus is inviting us to live the Eucharist in spirit of faith, of prayer, of repentance, of forgiveness, and especially of joy. Amen.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets. Bilang upo na Please all stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know the truth, we may make it ours by the worthy way of our life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, unwillingly entered into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Gilbert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Padre Pio, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be merited to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have that courage to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
My dear sisters and brothers, this is Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are invited to receive at his banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
supon espiti dono patris, Jesu pons biti aque. Cibus e potus noster, cibus e potus noster, in itinere, in itinere, ad Domus Dei. Mula sa lupa, sumibol kang masigla, matapos kang yurakan ng mga masasama, sumilang ang liwanag ng mga nawawala, tinapay na ang buhay, pagkain ng dukha. Jesu panis vite donum patris, Jesu pons vite aque. Cibus e potus noster, cibus e potus noster, in itinere, in itinere, ad Domus Dei. Jesus, food divine, be our strength each day, so we don't tire as we witness to your love and care. Through those in greater need, both near and far away, may we lead them back to you, oh, those who've gone astray.
Ang isasagawang second collection ay ginagamit sa patuloy na pagpapaunlad ng parokya at pambansang dambana ni Santo Padre Pio at para sa mga pangangailangan ng matatanda at may sakit na mga pari ng Arsidiosesis ng Lipa. Salamat po sa inyong handog.
Jesu panis biti donum patris, Jesu pons vite aque. Cibus e potus noster, cibus e potus noster, in itinere, ad Domus Dei.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, that lead those who have imbued with the heavenly mysteries to pass from the former ways to newness of life. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Panalangin ng pagtitiwala kay Santo Padre Pio. Padre Pio, taga Petrelcina, monghing banal, pintakasing santo ng milenyong kasalukuyan, gabay namin sa pagtahak sa landasing makalangit, takbuhan sa pangangailangan, huwaran ng pagtitiis. Sa iyo namin inilalapit aming mga kagipitan. Sa iyo po ibinibilin kalusugan at kabuhayan. Banggitin ng tahimik ang mga personal na kahilingan. Di mang karapat-dapat kami po ay pagbigyan. Bendisyonan at basbasan, maging ganap sa buhay. Lumayo nawa kami, umiwas sa kasalanan. Lumapit lagi sa Diyos, maging matatag at matibay. Sa mabuting balita ng pagliligtas, turuan mo kami nawa. Sa tuwi na ay makinig, magnilay at sumampalataya. Amin pong pakiusap itong mga kahilingan. Puso ay nagsisisi, nagtitikang taimtiman. Di na muling magkasala, sunod lagi sa Diyos Amang. Kaisa ng Espiritu at ni Jesus na tagapamagitan. Amen. Ang lahat po'y magsiupo para sa mga patalastas. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ang inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, sa pagnanais natin palawakin ang dokumentasyon at datos ng mga pilgrims and devotees na bumibisita sa pambansang Dambana, kami po ay nag-aanyaya sa inyong lahat na makilahok sa ginagawang pagkalap ng impormasyon na makakatulong sa pagpapaunlad ng ating turismong pangsimbahan. Makikisuyo po kami na paki-scan ng QR code na inyong makikita sa paligid ng simbahan at pakikumpleto ng mga impormasyong kinakailangan. Makakaaso po kayo sa aming pag-iingat ng private information na inyong ibabahagi bilang pagsunod sa batas ng Data Privacy Act of 2012. Ang inyong pakikiisa ay malaking tulong at susi sa tagumpay ng proyektong ito. May libreng laser tuli na gaganapin sa Divine Mercy Hall sa April 27, 2024 sa ganap na ikapito ng umaga hanggang ikalawa ng hapon para sa unang 100 mga binatilyong tumasino na walang kakayahang makapagpa-ospital mula edad 5 hanggang 16 na taong gulang. Maaari kayong magpalista sa opisina ng Pambansang Dambana o makipag-ugnayan sa mga detalyeng nasa screen hanggang April 23 lamang po. Ang susunod, maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng panalangin sa loob at labas ng ating simbahan. Magsitayo po lahat para sa pagbabasbas ng religious articles.
Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos Amang makapangyarihan upang tayo ay maging kawangis ni Kristo sa taimtim na pagdalangin sa tulong ng mga larawan at ng mga dasalan. O Panginoong Diyos, Ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagpapala at biyaya. Ibuhos po ninyo ang inyong bendisyon sa iyong sambayanan na nasa iyong harapan ngayon, kasama ang kanilang mga gamit sa pananalangin na nagpapaalala ng iyong kabutihan, kabanalan at pagmamahal sa amin, upang ang lahat na dumulog at magdasal ay magtamo ng iyong awa at biyaya. Loobin mong tularan namin ang iyong kabanalan at ang mga kabanalan ng mga santo magpa sa walang hanggan.
Amen. Ama namin, sumasalangit ka, sambahin ang ngalan mo, mapasa amin ang kaharian mo, sundin ang loob mo dito sa lupa para nang sa langit. Bigyan mo kami ngayon ng aming kakanin sa araw-araw at patawarin mo kami sa aming mga sala para nang pagpapatawad namin sa mga nagkakasala sa amin. At huwag mo kaming ipahintulot sa tukso at iadya mo kami sa lahat ng masama. Amen. Abaginaong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sama sa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ng iyong anak na si Jesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Ama namin, sumasalangit ka, sambahin ang ngalan mo, mapasa amin ang kaharian mo, sundin ang loob mo dito sa lupa para nang sa langit. Bigyan mo kami ngayon ng aming kakanin sa araw-araw at patawarin mo kami sa aming mga sala para nang pagpapatawad namin sa mga nagkakasala sa amin. At huwag mo kaming ipahintulot sa tukso at iadya mo kami sa lahat ng masama. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparanong una, ngayon at magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparanong una, ngayon at magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparanong una, ngayon at magpasawalang hanggan. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Heaven rejoice, for He is risen. Rise up, our Savior is here. Glory to God, proclaim His name, Jesus the Lord of